Hey there guys, it's Tina and I am back. And I hope you guys are staying safe and healthy and also taking some me time just to find your zen, find your center, and find some peace in these very trying times. Child, a lot is going on, but today we're gonna have some fun. We're just gonna kiki, have some light fun, and just laugh at some of these brands that are really trying it. Trying it, okay? So from the title of the video, you guys kind of have an idea of what's going on, right? Right? So I've been thinking about this idea for a while now, and I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna do it. So today, we're talking about brands that we would swipe left on. That's left, right? How does it work? I'm not sure, because I don't know how Tinder works. It's Tinder, right? It's Tinder that you swipe left or right. You know what? Don't question me. I don't know how these things work, okay? So, let me look it up. Yes, on Tinder, you swipe left. If you're not interested in whatever that person is bringing to your table, you see their profile, you see their pictures, and you're like, nah, I'm so good. And that is exactly what we're doing today with these different makeup brands. These are brands that just never caught my interest. Every time I see them in store, and I've swatched a few of these in store, and I've seen them online, and I'm just like, I'm not interested. I'm really not interested. So I am swiping left on these brands. So let's jump into it. And if you want to go ahead and do a video kind of like this, if you want to make it into a tag, feel free. Or if you want to leave the brands that you swipe left on in the comments below, that would be great as well. Let's have some fun. So we're going to start out with a brand that seems to be well loved here on YouTube by a different demographic than myself, and that is Physicians Formula. Now, they're well known especially for their butter bronzer. Everybody who is not my complexion and deeper here on YouTube seems to have this bronzer in their collection. And for the longest time, this bronzer was available in one shade, Solo Dolo. There was nothing lighter, nothing deeper, nothing for the girls, okay? And a lot of people complained, and they finally, oh my God, finally expanded the range into 6 shades now. So now they have a deep bronzer, a bronze Brazilian glow, endless summer, light bronzer, and a sun-kissed bronzer. But here's the thing, even their darker and deeper shades are still not suitable for those of us with more melanated skin. Even their deep shade is gonna barely show up on me, and I'm like, what the hell? And on top of that, they have the nerve to have one of the most expensive price points for drugstore products. Excuse me? Are you serious? The bronzer itself is $15.99. $16 for a bronzer in the drugstore? Who are you talking to? Absolutely not. And then they have other products in their line, like a blush that has 3 shades, and then they look like they just tossed in a token deep shade recently. Still not gonna work, whatever. And one of the only products that I've considered picking up is their mascara. I think they have this Argan Oil formula that Emily Noel raves about, and I'm like, I would try it out. But once I went up to their display and I looked at their shade range, I was like, absolutely not. Obviously this line is not for me. This brand, they don't want to include me, so okay, thank you so much. So this brand is the first one that I will swipe left on. You are not getting any of my coins because you obviously don't want to include me in your lineup. So thank you so much. Come again. Next up is a brand that I have no idea how they're still around, honestly, because I've never heard a positive thing said about any of their products. Anytime I've seen or heard them mention, it's a poor review, like no one is checking for their products. So how are they still in business? That is our glorious Jim Crow era makeup brand, Almay. What in the name of Ashdom is this? What is this caucasity? Have you seen Almay in store? Have you checked them out? I've seen them in Ulta, I've seen them in different drugstores, and I'm just like, how is this a brand? It's obvious that it's like whites only, like it's definitely living in the 1960s South where I wasn't even allowed to go into the store. Look at this trash, absolute trash. Their shade range is absolutely horrendous. I don't know where they're going with half the products. Nothing has been upgraded from literally the 60s. They look so tired. I'm just, every time I see them, I'm like, how? How are they still taking up space? How is this still allowed? What is this? And the price point, they're drugstore price points. Like, it's not even that bad. And yet no one really speaks about them. No one cares, and neither do I. So I'm swiping left. Absolutely done with them. Next up is a brand actually very laughable to me. This was a brand that was made popular on social media, on Instagram, with girls dripping things all over their face. Farsali. I was so surprised when I saw this pop up on Sephora. I was like, how did this make it in store? But it goes to show that influencers have a lot of pull and they can make or break a brand. This brand literally has been known for their dropper type products because they make for good graphic videos where they attract a lot of traffic, because what it looks like is that you're dripping some bodily fluids over your face, and apparently men want to see that, so here we are. Isn't that tragic that this is what really put Farsali on the map, right? So they started out with the unicorn essence, I think, or serum or whatever. Girls will drip it on their face, and next thing they're in Sephora and they have other drippy things that they're dripping all over their face. And I'm just like, how did this brand make it to Sephora simply skating on a gimmick? Like, literally their entire brand is built on a gimmick. They even have, what is this, like the gold, yeah, the brightening eye cream that is a gold because it is a turmeric base. And then you have a rose gold 24 karat moisturizing gel cream. It's simply a gimmick. It's simply what looks aesthetically pleasing on your Instagram feed. I'm gonna drip this juicy looking thing all over my face. And I just don't know. And the prices on these, it's $54 for the little drippy drop. How is this? I don't know, but I have swiped left every time. How, Sway? Now, I do want to smell it though, because I've heard good things about the smell, but that's not enough for me to spend $54 on a drippy drip thing. And I don't want to drip things on my face. In fact, for skincare, you don't want to have a container that you're dripping things out of, because it's just going to get contaminated and it's just a hot mess. I can't believe this brand really made it to Sephora. Who did this? Which one of y'all did this? Swipe left. Next up is another Instagram famous brand. This is actually created by an influencer. And I have nothing against this actual brand. It's just not something that I'm interested in. Now, the influencer that started this brand is MacDaddy on Instagram. He has 1.4 million followers and his real name is Angel Marino. And he has beautiful skin. He does beautiful makeup and he is also a professional makeup artist. So it makes sense for him to go ahead and make his own brand. He knows products, right? But I've never been interested in his brand. Like, every time I see the products, I'm like, yeah, they're cute, but not so much. He started out with loose powder highlighters, and maybe that's why I never got interested in his brand, because I don't care about glowing for the gods, and he's definitely all about the glow, and that's not my thing. So I was never drawn to the brand initially, but since then he's expanded the brand and he's also made it inside Sephora. So now he has pressed highlighters, which look amazing, beautiful nude lipsticks and nude glosses, and he also now has some eyeshadow palettes, which are the only things that I've actually been interested in. So he has this Midnight Maven eyeshadow palette, which is really beautiful, but it reminds me of Dominique Cosmetics, that Celestial Storm palette, so I'm not intrigued by that. And then the most recent one is the Supreme Nudes pressed pigment eyeshadow palette that it looks really beautiful, right? And that's the only one that I've kind of considered. But then I'm just like, I have so many nude palettes, I'm really not interested. I don't know, nothing about this palette really says come get me. Something about the brand, I've just never been drawn to it. Even when I go in store and see it, like I'll walk by the display, because Sephora will have a display of like their more indie brands and they'll have just select products. And I'm just never intrigued, I never wanna swatch them. I'm just like, yeah, all right. I mean, I really don't care. So I always swipe left on this brand, but I don't know, maybe one day that will change. But so far, nope, swipe left. Another influencer brand, and I know it seems like I'm going in on influencer brands, and I'm really not. It's just, they're the easiest to say no to, because I'm just like, I see that this might be a cash grab and I'm gonna give you time to sort yourself out, like figure out formulations. I don't trust you right out the gate. Like, I'm gonna give you space to breathe and develop the brand. And if it really flourishes, then I might wanna dip my toe in them. But Another influencer brand is from Manny MUA, Lunar Beauty. I've heard great things about the Lunar Beauty products, so it's not that they're getting poor reviews. And not for nothing, I've swatched these products in store. I've swatched a few of his eyeshadow palettes. So there's a Morphe store in one of our malls on Long Island, and I've gone in and I've swatched it. And now you can get some of these products in Sephora stores. Again, they're on that display with the indie brands, and I've swatched a couple of his palettes, and his eyeshadows feel fine. Like, they feel like they're decent. Something about the brand though just doesn't line up for me. The packaging doesn't match the eyeshadows in between. Like, he does beautiful, intricate packaging. I believe there was this witch packaging that he did that was so beautiful, and he pulled inspiration from like witch shows that he was watching, and I'm like, oh, this looks so magical and mystical. But then you open the palette and it's like, it looks like two different worlds. To me, it just doesn't match up. It's like wearing the wrong shoes with an outfit, and it turns me off completely from even getting the palette, because it's just something that's not going together for me. But I've heard great things, and he recently released a blush palette that people seem to really like. His highlighters seem to be getting a good review as well, and his lip glosses seem to be the best product in his lineup. I've heard so many people say his glosses are phenomenal, but I haven't seen any shades that are for me. So I'm just like, I'll see you when I see you. Like, I'll figure it out like later on, maybe a couple years from now, if you're really doing great still, then I might pick something up. But I'm like, I'm swiping left. I'm not interested at all. All right, let's get off of these influencer brands and move on to more mainstream brands that are in Sephora. So the next one up is the brand Lawless. Lawless, have you guys seen this brand? First of all, they have pricey products. I've seen the display in Sephora, I've touched their palette. They have this huge palette that's $64, and I'm just like, I don't want it. And now it's on sale for $45 because apparently no one else wants it. They have a foundation that's $46 and it has only 14 shades. So the shade selection, again, maybe not for me. Maybe you didn't want me to buy it, so I'm not interested. And now that's also on sale for $23. It used to be $46. Look at that. The blushes are the only things that kind of look intriguing, but I don't care that much about blush. Like, one color and I'm done. They also have a liquid lipstick, which is on sale as well. So there's something about this brand that's just not doing it for me. They have a gloss, they have highlighters, on sale as well, and they have a smaller eyeshadow palette that's $25. That's a nude palette. To me, it's just like, there's nothing exciting about this brand. There's nothing that's like, come try me, I'm so exclusive, I'm so sassy, I'm so sexy. It's just like, nope, swiping left. You look boring as hell. You don't look like, no, it's not for me, thank you so much, left. Then we have Lila B. Have you guys heard about this brand? I've only heard about how heavy their compacts are, and they're $48 for a foundation powder in a heavy compact, and it only has 4 shades. So to me, again, you don't want me to buy your products. The deepest shade is I'm gonna show you the deepest shade. No, they are rude. Then they have like lip oils and a primer and some cream cheek stain and a bronzer illuminator thing, and I just don't know. None of this pulls me in. Their eyeshadow quad, which is in a little compact of 4 shades, is $58. Who are you talking to? Are you out your goddamn mind? No, ma'am. I mean, the packaging looks sexy, and I've heard again that it's really heavy, so it's like, oh my god, it's so luxurious, but not for those prices, sweetie. And when your shade range is that trash, I already know you don't want my black dollars. So I'm just like, nope, swiping left, Lila B. You are left in the dust because I am not interested in any of your ash. Thank you so much. Let's talk about a newer brand that came out of nowhere. I just don't understand where this brand came from and why everybody and their mother was trying it out. So this is the Tower 28 Beauty. I haven't even cared enough to look up where they came from, right? But they're also at Sephora, and they have cream bronzers and cream blush colors. And it seems like a jelly lip gloss. And I don't know. What is this? Who declared that this was the new It brand? I don't know, but I'm swiping left because I just don't see the intrigue. Like, what? Who decided this was okay? And it's not like their products are pricey, because this Bronzino Illuminating Bronzer is $20. It's not that pricey. But not interested. Cream products, no ma'am, you can keep that. Swipe left. Next up, we have the brand Ilia. Ilia is also available at Sephora. I've never seen this in store, or maybe I just glazed over it and didn't care enough. But Ilia is just one of those brands that it's so, I don't know, it's so plain and blah, and their products are pricey, and I'm just like, why am I getting this again? I don't see the intrigue. And they have a decent amount of products. They have a mascara, they have foundation, they have primer, they have lip balm, they have eyeliner, they have loose powders. Like, they have things, and none of it speaks to me. The packaging is very basic, very just plain old creamy milky white packaging, and I don't know. Have you guys tried out Ilia? I need to understand why this brand is around. I don't know. I swipe left every time. I'm not interested. Left. Let me see their foundation range. $54. And they have how many shades? Girl, I know they're trying it with this shade range. Nope. Swipe left. Not interested. Definitely not interested after that. Oh, hell. Another obscure brand that just popped up out of nowhere for me one day is Stellar. What is this brand? They have a foundation range as well as a concealer, and it seems like they're being discontinued, and probably for good reason, because who are they? What are they doing? I don't know them. I don't know her. And yeah, I saw these products for a while. I thought they had way more products than this, but there was nothing intriguing about this brand. And I guess it's bye-bye, because now they are down to 4 products and they are on sale. So for good reason, I swiped left. So we're gonna swipe left on Stellar. This brand here is one that was mentioned by Hannah Louise Poston here on YouTube. Rowan Beauty, she loves their eyeshadows, like loves them. And she's the only one that I've really heard speak about them. But they have this textured, creamy glitter formula that it just melts on your skin, and it's very creasy according to Hannah, and she loves that because that's what she goes for, and she just goes crazy over these eyeshadows. And I'm just here like, que hora es? No ma'am, I'm just not interested at all. They also have like a couple other products, like a lip balm and an eyebrow pencil, but the main focus is their eyeshadows, and they're $29 for a single. So even if I wanted to say, all right, let me try it out, I'm just like, who's spending $29 on your single and I don't know you from nowhere? And then their quads, 4 shades, which are small eyeshadows, are $42. And I'm like, yeah, you could go somewhere. You could go somewhere. And if you're going to crease, no. And you look flaky and just, it doesn't look appealing to me. I really don't want it. I don't want it anywhere near me at all. I'm just not interested, so I'm swiping left. Now, the final brand is one that is very popular, and I followed this makeup artist influencer for a while, Linda Hallberg. She developed her own cosmetics line. She is gorgeous. Her looks, oh my God, you go on her Instagram and you're like, whoo, she is stunning. Her eye looks are mesmerizing. They're so interesting to see. Yet, I just haven't fallen in love with her brand. None of her products intrigue me. And she has quite a few products in her range. She has powders that I've heard excellent things about. Brushes, she has a sponge that I've also heard great things about. Her eyeshadow palettes and eyeshadow quad, she released one for holiday that was just glittery and shimmery and beautiful. She has crayons that are multi-use, so face, eyes, lips. She has lip products as well. All around, I've heard nothing but great things. Yet, I just can't pull the trigger. I'm just not interested. And one day I'm thinking it's gonna happen, but it hasn't happened yet. Her palettes look fun, I'm not gonna lie to you, and the crayons, I've heard such great things that I'm intrigued. But like, something is holding me back. I don't know what it is. One of her palettes, the Spectral palette, is this beautiful, colorful palette that you would think that's right up my alley. Yet, I'm over here like, No, maybe it's because it's international and I can't see it in store and I have to pay like an exorbitant amount for shipping, which I'm an ungrateful American, but here we are, right? I've just never ever picked up anything from her brand. I've always swiped left. It is what it is at this point. What am I gonna do? So there you have it, guys. That is it. Those are the brands that I always swipe left on. No matter what, I just can't seem to find the inspiration or the motivation to pick anything up from their brands. Do you have similar brands to these that you just look at and you're like, all right, thank you so much, have a good day? Or are some of these brands ones that you also would swipe left on? You let me know. But I thought this was just gonna be a fun video that we can talk about brands that just, they don't speak to me, they don't call me in, they don't make me feel warm and cuddly, and I just never ever try them out. So let me know what you guys think, and if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, share and favorite and all that good stuff. And I'm gonna keep going with this because I have a couple of other ideas floating around in my head, so you might see a couple more videos along this theme. So stay tuned for that. I'm gonna leave links to my Instagram and Twitter where you can follow me along. We're not politically correct over there, so if you're not interested in that, probably just stay away. But until my next video, which will be very soon, I'll talk to you. Bye, guys.